Gadgets on the beat.
Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, hi, I'm Cinn, and welcome to my channel. And in today's video, I'm going to be finally doing another entrepreneur video, or another video a part of my entrepreneur lifestyle, whatever my little thing is called. I'm doing another one of those videos, and today is going to be kind of like a Q&A shipping video, because I noticed that my shipping from home video is doing really good, but I'm also getting a lot of questions that you guys be like help answering, and I'm getting a lot of repeat questions as well, and some questions that are, you know, harder to answer through, I guess, replying to the comments. So I'll be doing this video to kind of answer and go through those things, but I'll also be doing an updated shipping video very soon, because I now actually use Shopify. I am no longer hosting my website through Wix. I switched to Shopify a few months ago. So, of course, my shipping routine is a little different, but it's also a little different from other stuff as well. So, I'll be, you know, coming out with that video too very soon. So, today I'm just going to go straight to my shipping video so that I can go through my comments and answer, you know, you guys' questions to the best of my ability to kind of help you guys understand things a little bit better. So, I'm going to start from the newest comments to the oldest one. So my first comment, well, my first question, a question I get a lot, that I was getting a lot, was what printer was I actually using? I was using the HP Envy 5052 printer I got from Walmart. It was very inexpensive. I had got that, I think it's the only one inkjet printer. I'm not 100%, but it's really in Walmart. It's very inexpensive. I got it around the time that I was in school. You know, when you buy stuff during school time, it'd be a little bit even more inexpensive. So that's the printer that I was using. I no longer use that printer. I will show you guys the printer that I currently use now in my updated video. I use a thermal printer now. I do not use a regular printer. So next question that a lot of people seem to be confused about, it says, so before posting your item to the site, you'll weigh it, correct? But how do you add shipping if someone has already paid for the item? Do you add flat rate shipping into the price where they pay? So the way that this works, this is what I do personally. So on my website, when I was with Wix or Shopify, I had it set where whatever USPS would charge for shipping, that's what I would charge, but I would put a dollar on top of it just to kind of give me a little bit of wiggle room, just in case my weight, like the weight of my package, is kind of off. So when I would get an item in, like I currently now sell clothes. We're gonna use clothes as an example. So I got some new inventory in now that I'm doing now. I have a new collection that probably by the time this video go up should be already available on my website. It's my new essentials collection, which has things like this, but I only have this in black. I don't have it in white. But you know, just basic little tops. I have one like little black dress. Just your essentials, your basics, what you should, you know, have or in your closet or whatever. So when I get that stuff in, I will literally, you know, tag it, package it how it would go into the package, and then I would weigh it. So if the weight is 5 ounces of the dress, then when I put the dress into my store where it says weight of the item, I will put 5 ounces. So when someone buys it on your website, USPS will say, okay, this package is going to be 5 ounces. We charge $3 to ship something that's 10 ounces, that's 5 ounces. So therefore, they're going to charge your customer that much money to ship the item, because that's what they're going to give to you so that you can pay to ship the item. So that's how that works. I weigh my items beforehand. I put the weight on my website, and I charge what USPS would charge for that. So if they charge $3, they're going to end up actually charging my customer $4, because like I said, I add a dollar on top just to make sure, because I could weigh the item wrong. So if I say that it's 5 ounces but it really weighs 10, instead of them charging $3, they might actually charge $4. But still, since I charge $4, it's still covered. It's kind of hard to explain. I hope that I'm not kind of like getting you guys confused. But bottom line, step by step of what you do, you get your item in the mail. Before, when you put it on your website, weigh it. Figure out the weight of it. Put that into your website so that your website hosting knows, okay, this item weighs X amount. So when your person is checking out, USPS is going to say, okay, this is the weight of their package. This is how much it's going to cost. So this is how much we're going to charge this customer for shipping. So that's how that works. Or you can do flat rate. If you feel like all your packages are going to be a certain weight, do flat rate. Or if you sell, like a good example, Glambot, whatever you order from her, her flat rate shipping is $9, because she's going to ship it priority, period. That's the easiest way to do it. If you get real confused with this shipping stuff, just do priority, because it's basic. Get you some priority boxes and charge flat rate, priority shipping, 2-day shipping. That's the easiest thing to do. So hopefully that helps that. So this one is saying, if you don't mind, I'm new to this and I wanted to ask, what is stamp and what do you do to prevent from having an insufficient balance? And lastly, how do you pay for the shipping costs? Please help because I want to start my own business. So this is for with ShipStation. I no longer use ShipStation to ship. I use ShipStation for like my Macari orders. But with ShipStation, you have to have a stamps account, because stamps is how you pay for shipping. So with ShipStation, it's kind of different. You have to give ShipStation the money beforehand. Like, it doesn't matter. If you're going to ship anything, you have to go ahead and put a balance up there. So, and their minimum is $10. So if you're going to ship a package, they're going to ask you for $10. You just give them the $10. And if your package costs $3 to like, it weighs like 2 ounces, that's gonna be about $3 to ship it. They're gonna take $3 from your balance. It's not gonna actually come from you, but you got to put the money in there before you ship it. Honestly, ShipStation is not hard if you take the time to sit there and learn it. That's what a lot of like the problem be, is that as soon as somebody gets started with something, instead of them just taking the time to look through it and figure it out, they want to go ask questions. Just sit down for 10 minutes and look through the website. I promise it's not hard. All of this stuff that I'm telling y'all, I learned on my own because it's not hard. Like, you're going to have some trial and error. Like, of course, when I first started my website, I had a few trial and errors, but you live and you learn. Just with ShipStation, kind of sit down, take the time to learn it. And if you don't understand it still, ShipStation has customer service. And they also have, like, helpful videos and little articles to help you navigate it. So use those resources and it should help you a lot, because it's kind of hard to explain when I'm not sitting there with you showing you like step by step basically. So this one says, if I may ask, when you're doing shipping, is the return address your actual home, or can you change the address that shows where it's shipped from? So when I first started, my return address was from home, which I'm so glad. I really recommend that you guys do not. I went and got me a P.O. box at my local post office. And that is my return address. I love it. It just makes me feel more secure, more safe, because some people are just crazy and I don't want to just have my address out to the world just because. So you can definitely change your return address. You just have to go actually have you that. The address that you use has to actually be an address that you can get mail from, because a lot of people will go on your website, buy something, put in an invalid address, and it gets shipped back to you. So if you're just using an address that's just whatever, you're not going to get that package back. You're not going to get none of that stuff back. So if you do want to change your return address, make sure you get a P.O. box or you actually use an address that you can go to just in case a package gets sent back. Okay, and then this is the same person. They said, when you take it to the post office, are you waiting in line to meet with the people behind the desk to ship it, or do you just drop it off? It depends. In the beginning, I used to just drop it off in the little thing, but then I started actually taking it. Like, if I have a big box or something, I take it on the inside. If I have just little packages, I will put it in the thing. But what I actually do now is I literally go to my mailbox. I would get up and package orders before my mail lady would run, and I would take them and put them in my mailbox and flip the little red thing up, and she would take them, she would scan them, and she would take them to the post office. It's literally that easy. I don't do no schedule pickup because it's the same thing. When you schedule a pickup, you're basically scheduling your mail person to come to your actual like porch or whatever to pick up your package. If I have a small amount of packages that can fit into my mailbox, I just put in my mailbox to keep it easy for her. She can just pull it out, do whatever, put the mail in. But if it's stuff that's too big, my post office is literally like 2 minutes down the road. I just ride down there, take it to the actual inside of the store, and give it to the lady. So you can do one of those three things. You can put it in the drop-off box, you can actually take it to the person behind the counter, or you can put it in your mailbox for your mail person to pick up. So those are the three things you can do with that. Okay, this says, what calculates your shipping costs, Wix or ShipStation? Neither. USPS calculate my shipping costs. I put on my website how much all my stuff weighs. When a person checks out, my website kind of like says, okay, this is how much all the stuff weighs, sends the information to USPS. USPS says, okay, this is how much it will cost to ship that at this price, and then that's what they display to the customer. That's kind of how it works. So USPS calculates the price, the customer pays the price, the money comes to me. When I ship it, I pay it to the Shopify, who pays it to USPS. As long as you put how much your stuff weighs on your website, everything else is handled. You don't have to do nothing else. If you put on your website that this dress weigh 5 ounces, this pair of pants weigh 2 ounces, this necklace weigh 3 ounces, these lashes weigh 1 ounce, they will take care of everything else. Everything else is done. All you have to do is when you package up your stuff, put it on the scale, weigh it, and then put the total amount that it weighs into whatever you're shipping through. If you ship through Shopify, Shopify will say, this is how much we charge your customer. You tell them, well, my package weighs 5 ounces. Then they're going to say, this is how much you have to pay for shipping. And then you pay it. It's that easy. Don't make it harder than what it is. It's really not. Okay, and this is kind of like repeating a lot of stuff, but they're saying, how do you get your website to charge the people based off of like where they live and stuff? Because if you know, depending on how far you stay and the weight of the package, the price can change. So the price of you shipping something that's 2 ounces that's in your state versus shipping a package that's 2 ounces across the state is going to be different, of course. But again, if you put on your website where USPS charged the customer based off of what they would charge, it's that simple. If you do flat rate, it's not going to do that. It's just going to say, well, okay, you say it's $3, so we're going to charge them $3. That's why I do it where USPS charges them what they would charge in general. So like I said, the easiest thing to do is to set your website like that. It'll never fail. Someone asked me, why do you use ShipStation if Wix offers some of the same features? My answer was, it's just a preference. But honestly, because when I first started with Wix, I never used their shipping thing. When I first did shipping, I was just going to the post office and letting them do everything. And then second, I think I was watching somebody video on YouTube and they actually used ShipStation, and ShipStation was offering a free month trial. I used it. I liked it. So that was really all that was. Because now that I'm with Shopify, I don't use ShipStation. Unless, like I said, I'm shipping off something from like Macari. And also, if I make a mistake on my end or if something gets broken. Like I had a necklace that got broken in transit. So when I reshipped it, of course, I didn't charge the customer for shipping or anything. When I reshipped a new item, I used ShipStation because I didn't have it in my Shopify store because I had done shipped it. So I had to reship on ShipStation. So again, it's just a preference. I just like to have it for just in case I have to ship things that didn't come through my website. It's just preference. Y'all, this video is actually a little more stressful than I thought it was gonna be, but only because y'all are making this a lot harder than what it is. A question was, what scale do I use? I just got a scale from Amazon. You can honestly use a scale from Walmart, a food scale. As long as your scale is, it can read in ounces and pounds, you can use it. It doesn't matter. Oh yeah, this will be the last question. Well, it's two more. So one says, do you have to manually type in each address into ShipStation, or do you somehow connect ShipStation with Wix? You just connect it. It's going to integrate with Wix, so every time you get an order and you refresh ShipStation, the order is going to automatically go over. That easy. Do you have to pay any extra money with ShipStation? Yes, you do. It's a monthly fee. I think the cheapest plan they have is $9.99, and that's if you ship 50 or less packages. And then I think the next one is $20, and that's up to 500 packages. Don't quote me, I don't know, because like I said, I haven't used ShipStation in so long. So that's that. Another option is, I do offer, we can get on the phone for 45 minutes for $50, and I will help you down to a T. We can FaceTime, we can phone call. If you are in my area and you would like to meet so that I can actually hands-on show you what to do, let me know. Again, it's 45 minutes for $50. Because nothing in life is free. If you need help with all of that, let me know. You can either comment down below. I will let you know how to get into contact with me. Or you can find me on my social medias. Do it that way. Like I said, shipping is not hard. But it really seems like a lot of you guys are making it harder than what it is. But again, I'll be doing another in-depth video on how I ship. I got to get my area back together so that I can show you guys how I do it. Anyway, if you guys enjoyed this video and you learned something from it, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know if you have any more questions so that when I do my next video, I can either answer those questions in there or actually show you guys in action what needs to be done. So hopefully I'll see you guys in my next one. Make sure you stay tuned for that video. This is Cinn signing off. Peace.